Hey there, folks, and welcome back to another train simulator video. We're, of course, back on the Powder River Basin by Tomcat. But I'd like to clear the air and get something out of the way. The first video I made of the Angora sub had a lot of comments and people talking about the fact that they're unable to get a hold of Mark at 3D Trains to get the Tehachapi assets for this route. For that, I don't know what I can tell you. I got this almost a year ago, these assets, the 3D Trains Tehachapi, and it took him a while to get back to me because he kind of just does it in his spare time. It's not a 100%, you know, working route that he does, and when he can get to stuff, he can get to stuff, from my understanding. So best I could say is, you know, I just wait it out. If not, ask PayPal for a refund, you know, until maybe you hear from him or maybe see a little activity on, you know, his website, on the 3D Trains website, because this route right here is not going anywhere. You may have a case of, you know, FOMO or a fear of missing out, but this route right here, it's not even complete, so you're not really going to miss anything. It's very much complete, but he's still working on this route as well. So if you're new to this in the series and you're wondering what the hell I'm talking about, I would implore you go back and watch the first video, which talks about the route itself, the requirements and all that good stuff. But as per the last video, my mic took a dump in the last like 20 minutes or so. So it was just camera panning around Alliance, Nebraska, which was pretty damn useless and a bit embarrassing. But we're back. We're back in Alliance, Nebraska. A little bit about Alliance, Nebraska, as I always like to do. I like history. Hopefully you do as well. The town was originally named Grand Lake, and the CB&Q Railroad arrived in about 1888, and the superintendent didn't think the name fitted the area. He wanted it to be something quick, snappy, snazzy, and fast. This was 1888, mind you. But he wanted to change it to one word and closer to the beginning of the alphabet, which he reckoned would be better for business. He was the superintendent. Anyway, so they named it Alliance. Anyway, A, first letter of the alphabet, obviously. But Alliance sees a absolute mega butt ton of coal trains daily. They surely did back in its heyday. They still do a little bit, but they see all kinds of traffic here as well, because it's a tri-forked devil alliance. Let's see, we're going northeast, south, or no, sorry, northwest, south, and then east. But it is most definitely a railroad town, and it's pretty much stayed that way. But it's in the, it's almost up in South Dakota. It's in the like northwest quadrant sector vicinity of Nebraska. So again, just a refresher, this is the Powder River Basin, which is going to take place in South Dakota, Nebraska, and Wyoming. But it also hosts a massive BNSF mech diesel shop and Progress Rail shops as well. Now what you see here, this is the southbound and northbound yard for the Angora sub. So the Angora sub effectively ends here in Alliance, which is just to the north here. And then south is where we came from in the last video, Bridgeport. So that's way down yonder. But again, you know, this route is created faithfully. The assets that are used, and why that 3D Trains Tehachapi is so important, it's because a lot of this stuff and a lot of the building assets are from that, the grasses as well, I didn't mention it last time, the Vulcan Productions tree and grass pack is used in this as well, but it's, everything just blends so nicely. This grass right here looks so much better than that, you know, bog standard train simulator slash railworks grass that we have 9 times out of 10, and it fits the area so well. Got your whistle boards, shorty signals, Got a little shop over here with a bean sniff Super Duty. Or is that when they started calling them Super Duties? I think it is. Super Duty. We got a train sitting here ready to go southbound, ready to pull. Now, this yard would predominantly be filled, you know, stem to stern. But to save memory, because this is over 500 route miles once again, you know, I just put as much as I could get away with without my computer, you know, doing a magic trick and turning itself into a fireball. But just got a bunch of rando stuff sitting here in the yard. Over here is where they store engines, these tracks right here. Can kind of see there. And then over there is just northbound and then southbound. And then the main, the kind of darker ones over there, those would continue either east or north. Got a couple of spurs here. But again, like, I just love getting high above like this and just looking at these crops and farms, because this is what they look like. You know, we don't have a lot of these down here in the south where I'm from, these giant circle crops. So they're interesting to see, and most definitely are not UFO alien life forms. Those are legit farms and crops. Got a little pond over there, probably for irrigation. Some farmer's farm in his house. But it's a damn gorgeous map. I love this map. Every time I load in, it's just, you know, it's like taking a tour of Nebraska. So far, I mean, we're not even in South Dakota and Wyoming yet, but I always thought of Nebraska as just, you know, corn. But they, you know, they do a lot of other stuff, including beans and, you know, other agriculture, ag businesses. But, and it's not just flat either. You know, there's the sand hills, which we rolled through, is one of my most favorite part of the route so far, is sand hills back south. Just gorgeous scenery, just up and down, up and down. Coming up on here to the Y. Got a little bridge. I love this section right here. And this this maintenance away, this fill down here. That looks amazing. That's like some of the best looking stuff that's supposed to look like that I've ever seen in train sim. It's just so clean. There's no jagged, stupid looking edges anywhere. Anywhere at all. you know what? That's fine. I honestly don't give a damn. For what this route is, that's fine. But even like right here, when it's kind of blended together, these two terrain bits, it looks amazing. Amazing big old light tower right there, this area. And it looks like this too. And you know, he put all these weeds down in the ditches and whatnot, and over here you just got this little reservoir and you got some weeds and bushes and lily pads and all that stuff down in there as well. That's a pretty sight. You can go just about any angle in any area of this map and it's just absolutely stunning. We'll head over to the BNSF yard here in a second. We'll just kind of check out this area. He has nailed this. This is one of those areas that I feel like you don't see a lot in train sim on routes. Just the way everything's laid out, it looks organic. It looks natural. It doesn't look fabricated. You know, there's just random stuff everywhere. The grass and the weeds grow randomly. There's random patches. You know, the way the dirt, you know, just trucks and tractors and all kinds of crap just been making their way through here. You know, it looks good. All these just garbage bags. What is that? A sofa? There we go. That's where the hobos can chill when they're waiting on their train right there. Just kick back, watch them roll in, go grab one or don't. I do not condone that. YouTube reasons. But yeah, just all the stuff laying everywhere. It looks amazing. A couple of shops and sheds over here. The sun's setting to the west. Now, these tractor trailers here are, I believe, are from the RCAP pack, which you'll need, which you can go get off Railworks America. But, they're, you know, they're nice. They're a bit old, but they're still really nice. far better than a lot of stuff that comes, you know, straight off the Steam store if you buy a root anyway. That's nice. Got these vents on top of the roof there. It looks really nice. I don't know how else to say it. Little power station there. This is Alliance, Nebraska. We'll continue that way just a moment in the video, but I'm just going to focus on Alliance because, like I said, my mic took a dump in the last video, which we were in Alliance. But just when you look at this from above, it is mastercraft. Absolute mastercraft. Here's the town over here. Just gorgeous. It's the parking lot for the bean sniffer employees. Got a tower, microwave, and radar dishes. So we got the BNSF shops, engine shops. I just set a couple of random engines. Yes, a lot of these are extremely old. I just set them here for the fact that they don't take a lot of resources, you know, and just yard filler. And there's absolutely nothing wrong with that, because if you want to get up on this son of a gun, hey, just compare it to the, you know, I'm sorry I'm laughing, but you know, this is great, you know, 72 years ago, but now, you know, it just doesn't belong. But it, you know, it looks good from afar. You can't really tell. It's just yard filler. Got a bunch of stuff, though, in and out of the shops. And the shops themselves look amazing. And the grounds and all that. Now, over here is their bad order axle shop. Whatever the hell else they're going to do over here. So, I just sat some random colgons. So, they got it divided. The actual offices here. Engines. Cars. I'm not entirely sure what this little bit over here is. But it's, you know, it's all very highly detailed. Very, very... very, very. Couple of random bits right here where they just bring in, you know, new axles and wheels and whatnot. Those two little spurs, backside of the shops here. Got the train wash. Get all squeaky clean. I'm assuming that's what that is. Another one there. Got your fuel depot right here, which looks very nice. Even this, man, where this is raised up over the rails like that, that's so clean. So clean. I love seeing rails embedded in cement like that. Something about it gets me all hot and bothered. Or in the sand like this. You know, old disused rail. Got a couple of really old elevators and silos over here sitting in the weeds. I love the way this looks. It is this, you know, Tomcat, this guy, he's got an eye for stuff. And it looks so natural and so right. And, you know, this kind of stuff is what keeps me coming back to train sim. You know, because people do continue to work on stuff like this. You know, what with all the kind of just schmeg that gets dumped on the Steam store that people just happily, you know, gobble up, that, you know, to each their own, but I want to say maybe they don't really care that much or don't know any better. you know, it's kind of sad when you want some nicer, newer stuff and it's just kind of the same old, same old. So we got the other yard here going eastbound. Pop open the map here. Hopefully the game doesn't crash. It is very memory intensive. So here is our BNSF shops here. Here's this yard. Now, oh, and this right here, Trinidad Bean. We went over this in the first video. This is one of their processing facilities here. So the other one was down south in Bridgeport. This one here is one of their processing facilities. So they bring stuff here and process them, whatever that entails, getting, you know, little pieces of cow dung and dirt and whatnot washed off the beans, I guess. And then this way, this massive facility, the Alliance Swepco shop and storage, Sand Hill Sub. Now this is not finished scenery. I don't know if he's going to finish the scenery or not, but the tracks are there and it is gorgeous. I mean, just look at that. you know, just tracing that with your eyes, it's just absolutely gorgeous. But as of right now, that's just rails and trackage, if I'm not mistaken. But yeah, so that is Alliance, big railroad town, one of the big, probably the biggest town on the map in its entirety, that I've seen yet. Anyway, I haven't even been, honestly, haven't even been, on more than about 30% of this route so far that I've seen. Here's that area down here. As you can see, it's not finished. So, like, as I mentioned in the first video, this is very much a work in progress, even though a lot of it looks finished and you could most definitely run it to your heart's content. Here's that yard here in Balloon. But, you know, it looks like he's working on it because he's got the fields and pastures and stuff like that out here and silos. There's Trinidad Bean. So you can most definitely bring some hoppers down here and swap them out and switch them in. Man, his bridges and easement work. Look at that. That is a spicy, spicy meatball. Very spicy. Like you need a whole glass of milk after that one. Very spicy. Just looks amazing back here. Moving on, town of Alliance, got your ball fields, Friday night lights, you know, small town like Alliance, probably big deal, little league baseball. God dang it, Billy, I said hit the ball, are you blind? You know, some little kid's dad yelling at him, maybe he had one too many. It's a gas station, Texaco, these look great as well. Stuff like this really adds to these routes, and you know, a lot of shit you're going to get off the steam store is not going to have this stuff. You know, that's the beauty of these freeware routes and this, you know, the Tehachapi from 3D Trains and the RCAP assets. But yeah, it's Alliance. Got a little main street scooting down that away. Shopping center, some offices, all the neighborhoods. It's just one of those towns where it's just every, it looks like every road is legit just, you know, a square. Right angles everywhere you go. Some old disused tracks here. Now this is what I believe, I'm pretty sure it's supposed to be fairly modern, the way he's built this. And sadly, a lot of these old companies and co-ops and granaries have been bought up by this larger company and several other larger companies and condensed and consolidated and all that good stuff, which we'll go over once we start heading north a bit here. So that's what I'm imagining is going on here with some of these lesser or disused ones. Not sure what the heck that is. Those look like squished stoves. yeah they got the burners and the knobs. I'm not sure what that's supposed to be though, but you could look on the map and probably see that, and it is there. And you'll definitely be able to tell what the hell it is. But anyway, we're about to start heading that way up the Butte Sub, which this video I completely forgot to even mention. This is about the Butte Sub from Alliance, Nebraska to Edgemont, South Dakota. All right, so we got a general manifest set up and we're about to pull northbound out of Alliance onto the beginning of the Butte Subdivision. this whole area is gorgeous. There is a ton of industry around here as well, which I've tried to set up to the best of my ability. Got a road going under the tracks here, which always looks very nice. Love these bridges, this ironwork and how it looks. Gorgeous. Got an old dead track over here. I think that's some sort of progress rail something. That's RJ Corman. Okay. I don't know why I was thinking progress rail. It's RJ Corman derailment 1, derailment 2. Those tracks there. We continue pounding north. Leave an alliance behind. As you can see, there's no cars that I left there, just to save on, you know, memory and all that good stuff, because it is train simulator. It's very finicky and fickle. Another ballpark, staple of Americana, especially nowadays, is how they look. Got the quad ballpark in each direction. Like a couple of fields just plowed, ready to be sown or what have you. I'll go ahead and crank it up a couple notches here. Got a horse farm down here and another very, very nice looking bridge. Ponies get to watch these trains go by. And it's about a 0.8% grade right here, and there is a very, well, slightly prominent grade coming up that we're headed to. A lot of you probably already know what's down here, but it is 1,000% the gem of this subdivision on the PRB that we are headed to. Got our 60 speed board coming up. So one of the first things we're coming up to here is one of the industries. So this is New Alliance Bean and Grain, which is huge in the area. They have some stuff down in Bridgeport as well. So I just got a couple of hoppers set up here. Very large facility. So you can turn tricks there. This over here is Kelly Bean Co. I think they started in like 1927, so they're a fairly old company as well. A little private company versus, you know, a larger ag company, I guess you could say. Let me notch back a little bit here. We're speeding a bit. Oh, noes. And I don't think to this current day Kelly Bean does any more rail service. I think it's all mainly Nikes, that's close. I think it's all mainly tractor trailer. But anywho, I don't think this is supposed to be present day to a degree. I'm gonna say within the last 20 years probably, which is relatively modern. A little ditch over here just filled with water. I love stuff like this. It just looks natural. All natural. Over here is Walther Farms. They handle potatoes, potato productions. So I just sat a couple of old rando reefers here, BNSF reefers, which I'm assuming they're turning the soil here as well. And then this, I love this scene right here. So you've got all these big boys sitting right by the rails. And the headers kind of laying off to the side. Bunch of tires, header trailers. Even say John Deere, Fendt. These combines look great though. Absolutely great. Very nice sitting there. Couple more back yonder as well. See if we missed anything. I think that's it for here. And then up here, we've got West Plains LLC. So they are a... If I'm not mistaken, they're a very, very large company. They kind of bought out a lot of, you know, smaller co-ops and farms and whatnot. And this is just one of their, you know, massive dumping sites here. So I just got a train set up like it just came in here and offloaded. Or onloaded, sorry. But it's got a nice loop to it as well, which is pretty cool. Old farm sitting back yonder. And you're probably thinking, as was I, you know, right around this area, like, man, this is flat. Well, don't get used to it, is all I can say. Because it comes up quick. This is an absolutely gorgeous area. It's got to be in real life. See what else we got here. There's Berea loader, Berea 1 and 2. So these two up here are also owned by this company, or this LLC, West Plains. So they've got stuff all over the region. We'll be checking that out here in a minute. Just a lonely crossing out in the middle of nowhere. But gorgeous all the same. Road just disappearing up over that hill. And we're in run 8. What's that Guilford boxcar doing in there? And Saskatchewan! They get around. No biggie. I like to mix it up. Just for funsies. So here we have Berea. This is Berea 1 and 2 sightings. Grain as well. For the most part, far as I know, but it's definitely ag production and processing. But West Plains LLC, which is a massive company that kind of, you know, bought smaller farms and companies and co-ops and all that stuff over time and have just created a conglomerate or however the hell that works business-wise. Don't really know. But they own it now. They take care of it. They run it. So I got a couple of hoppers sitting here. Back behind us is the other siding, which we'll see in just a moment, which has got some general freight for whatever reason. I think I got a couple of boxcars sitting there and some reefers. it's switching over to a single track up there. I might be going a bit fast, but hopefully she'll hang on to the iron. Here's the other siding I was talking about. She's got a couple of random boxcars sitting here. So this is Berea, which is right here on the map. 1 and 2. And that's a loader as well, so I'm assuming that means it is animated, which is pretty nice. Up next, as we stick our head out the window like a Labrador, is Hemmingford. Got a good sized little yard. Now there's a spur right there that goes off to the right. You can see sitting in the weeds, kinda. There are several of those. For whatever reason, I don't really know. Possibly for pushers, for what you'll see here in a moment, but I don't know. Could be for maintenance stuff. Not really sure. It's essentially just a straight arrow back there from basically Berea to Hemmingford. And then after that, it's anything but really. And here is Hemmingford and Hemmingford Co-op. Basically, these massive silos. Very nice, quaint little cozy looking town. Got several sidings. Definitely industry as well. Let's see, where are we at here? Misplaced my mappage. Yeet, there we are. So we got a loader back here. So I just had a couple of hoppers back there as usual. The main runs right through. It's like we got a yellow that flipped up on us there, but it's got a ton of storage, so you could do quite a bit of work there, I would imagine. We'll scooch through it after we watch the train come out. Got this nice old grown over field. The fence lining it. That crossover speed might be a little high. Maybe. Might want to go ahead and bring the notches down. Good God Almighty, the thing is leaning like a son of a gun. Anyway, Hemmingford. Very nice little town. Once again, just absolutely detailed to the nth degree. Got some more ball fields over here. Just trucks, storage. Love the trees. Gas station. Got your truck pump out here. And the regular car pumps over here with some nice little flowers. Mobile gas. There's the town. Nice flag sitting there. A bunch of grain trucks sitting here. Just put a couple of flats there. Don't really know why. Just figured they looked right there. And some big ass towers. All for them grain trains. Just scooch right on through. And you got like three storage tracks here essentially. So there's a lot of stuff to work with here in Hemmingford. But it's a nice looking little town again. Just, you know, even the what I would consider the little smaller things on this map like this just look so damn good. Now, for complete transparency, we are just to the north of Hemmingford. Actually, not but a couple miles. And this is the terrain in this section. It is not a very large section, but this is how it looks. I would imagine that this is largely unfinished, even though, you know, the rail bed, you know, as always, looks fantastic. It's signaled, it's marked, it's got the tanks down there. It looks good. It just doesn't have the, you know, trees, buildings, assets, farms, all that stuff yet. Even got some power lines out there, looks like. So it's ready to go. It just hasn't been done yet, but it's not a very large portion. But this next portion is very much finished, and you'll see here in a moment. All right, so passing through the area, which is missing a lot of scenery, which is not yet finished, we are approaching Crawford Hill and the very unique to the area, the Pine Ridge Escarpment on buttes, or kind of like flat mountaintops, if you will, if you want to think of a butte. Kind of looks like it's spelled Butte, just so we're on the same page. It's a butte. Not a butte. But anyway, this is the area, and it is filled with some very, very nice looking pine trees. It is a lot more elevated and de-elevated in this area, and filled with not only a bit of history, but just some of the most gorgeous scenery I have yet to see on this route. And like I said before, you know, I've only seen a small fraction of what there is to offer with this place. this is the beginning or the end, which either way you want to look at it, of the stunning Crawford Hill in northwest Nebraska. And this area just is so gorgeous as well. Just everything, again, from the right-of-way to the ballast, you know, the bridge, the embankment, the trees, bushes, it just all fits so, so well. And we are struggling up this 0.8% grade, and this is the lighter side of this grade, as the other side is, I want to say, like 1.5%. But Crawford Hill, this area we're coming up to, train should be coming around the bend there any minute. This is Belmont, by the way. There we go. I can hear the horn. Just making sure it didn't derail and is flying off into space. Crawford Hill is a helper district with an average of 1.5% eastbound grade between Crawford, which is at 3,678 feet, and Belmont, where we're currently at, which is at 4,499 feet. It's got the glorious and gorgeous Pine Ridge escarpment with ponderosa pines, which have a very specific, unique look. And on the other side behind us here is Crawford, the town of, which is a fairly large town, which has helpers manned in the event that they need to assist trains going up the ridge. And here we need to start putting the brakes on. I'm gonna go ahead and let off the throttle here. But this is Belmont, and this area is absolutely gorgeous. This little valley or gorge down in here, and what you'll see off to the right here is very, very freaking cool, especially the fact that he added it. This is the old Belmont Tunnel right here, off to the right. This used to be a railroad down here, right below us, this road here. Here it is, the Belmont Tunnel. Pause it here for a moment. This is a 700-foot railroad tunnel near the ghost town of Belmont, which there obviously isn't much of a town here left anymore, built by CB&Q in 1888, but was sadly bypassed in 1982 with the trackage that you see here. Very neat area, though. Here it is, the beginning or the end of the famed Crawford Hill and Horseshoe, which is up around the bend there. And by God, if this isn't some of the best distance scenery in Train Simulator as a whole, it is massive. But direct from the Wikipedia horse's mouth, a little bit about Crawford Hill for you. Basically, in 1888, Chicago, Burlington, and Quincy Railroad began building a line from Alliance, Nebraska to Edgemont, South Dakota, which is exactly the current train that we're on here, to compete with the Fremont, Elkhorn, and Missouri Valley Railroad. The challenge came when conquering the Pine Ridge Escarpment. Upon reaching Belmont, engineers determined the only means of success would be constructing the Belmont Tunnel through the east face of the escarpment, with a steep grade and tight curves down to the settlement known as Crawford. In September of 1889, the CB&Q succeeded, establishing a small operations base in Crawford, as well as a connection with the Fremont, Elkhorn, and Missouri Valley Railroad. Blah, blah, blah. Many, many years later, it became property of, I think, about the 70s, the Burlington Northern Railroad, and, you know, so on and so forth. Here we are today. But good golly, Miss Molly, it is gorgeous, and it is a massive downhill slope. We're on a 1.8% right now, so I'm slapping the brakes on this son of a gun. I should have popped on the dynamics, but I am but a pleb. Dear God, hold on. Hang on. Train ain't even that heavy, man. Okay, there she goes. Just stunning scenery. And some of the coolest real YouTube rail fanning videos of Crawford Hill. Back in the 90s, I'd say late 90s, probably. Just absolutely stunning. Come up a bit higher here. Swings out around that ridge there, begins the horseshoe. The terrain though, I mean, it looks so realistic, these dips and dives and the way the trees and bushes are laid out. It is just beautiful out here. Achingly beautiful. I'm a sucker for natural scenery, and this is it, man. It's gorgeous. Here's the first main curve. It's nuts though, the real videos I've seen of this place, just watching these trains leaned in on the grade. You know, they're not going very fast, but it's still a sight. Typically trains that are, you know, 130, 40, 50, 60 some odd tons aren't going to be hauling butt. This isn't a coal train, albeit, but still. This little road, I believe it's called Horseshoe Road in real life. The rock outcrops over here, and you can see where they just straight cut through the ridge, you know, to build this railroad, and he just laid it out there perfectly. It looks so damn good. There's only so many times you can say it, but I can't help myself. It does. It looks freaking amazing. Back that way is Crawford. Round about that way is, or not Crawford. Back that way is Belmont. That way is Crawford. I had it bass backwards. ghostly groaning sound. Which, by the way, as with the first video, these are the Searchlight Simulations jointed rail freight pack 02 with the lovely looking sounds. And here's the biggin through that wash down there. I mean, talk about scenery. You know, I've said it. I'll say it again. Horseshoe Curve can kiss this thing's ass. You know, I'm an East Coaster, too. And it can just put on the reddest lipstick and kiss its ass, because this is gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. See the open Butte Ridge off to the right there. And even, you know, just sitting here looking around down in the wash there, where there's obviously like a drainage basin, and how it's more green, more trees growing down in there, you know, because they're obviously getting more precious H2O. Just little details like that. It's just uncanny how good this route looks. It is. It is. Man, what a view. Any angle. There's Soldier Summit assets, I believe, these rocks here. They look amazing, though. And we're getting down on the slanted side here. Up out of the Butte, or the Butte. I tell you, man, if it weren't for, you know, freeware creators that kind of just make stuff in their free time and don't necessarily try to make money off of it, you know, but even, you know, if they do try to make money off of it, they have a passion and they want stuff to be right. But this is just amazing. There are not many North American routes, in my opinion, that can contend with this. Not many at all. And here we go, headed down into Crawford. Crawford's got a bit of cool history as well, and I do like my history. It just kind of makes the place seem a bit more alive than just some place on a map, you know. Everything's got history to it, and sometimes good, sometimes not so much. But Crawford's interesting, not only with the... what the hell's the name of that railroad? I already forgot it. And the CB&Q competing to get there anyway. It was effectively a tent city, like a lot of these old frontier towns that sprang up in about 1886. So just into Civil War, post-Civil War, people trying to get away, people trying to get out west, all the madness and craziness. And it was Fremont Elkhorn Missouri Railroad. That's the railroad I'm thinking of. But they passed through on their way to Wyoming because they were heading west. And for some reason or another, I'm not entirely sure. I think I saw somewhere that it was named for a fellow named Emmett Crawford, because the town's obviously called Crawford, who was a lieutenant at the nearby Fort Robinson, which was just a bit west of here. He was killed down in Mexico in the 1800s. But the place was a rambling, bambling town with a... I'm trying to think of an eloquent name that they would have been called back then. A house of pleasure, you know, poker, all kinds of fun stuff, and, you know, brothels, that's the word, saloons, all that kind of stuff. It was an old frontier town, you know, and visited by, you know, many famous old-timey Western types, such as, Calamity Jane, who was, known to travel here after she had left, Deadwood. For whatever reason, and she was definitely known to have visited Deadwood with what's his name? God dog it, I can't think of his name now. Wild Bill Hickok. So anyway, it's pretty interesting, and it came into a town of its own after just being essentially a tent city. The second railroad, the CB&Q, got there in 1889, which just kind of doubled the economy and population, if you will. So, and there we have it today. That's what Crawford is to this very day. BNSF's got a fairly prominent size office there. There's a big... I believe bovine or cattle market as well, which is modeled down here in Crawford, that Tomcat lovingly crafted and created as well. It's just a gorgeous area, cool area. Something about old frontier and old west to me that, you know, being a southerner and an easterner. Distance. I believe the farther kind of north, west, north we go kind of touches on the Black Hills area, which is absolutely gorgeous as well, and which the town of Deadwood that I just mentioned is located within. Now there is a tiny, tiny, tiny bit of a line that is supposed to go to Deadwood. I don't know if it'll ever be finished, but the like 1 or 2 miles that it has is astounding. So we'll see. It's gorgeous. Anyway, next up, Crawford. So we are now in the railroad term eastern outskirts, but it's actually like the southern, I guess, of Crawford. The town And it's got equally beautiful scenery out here. Some big old tanks sitting up on that ridge. Trains coming down off the mountain back that way, or the hill anyway, as they call it. It's a pretty large hill. Got this nice cut down into here, which again is just created so nicely. The bridge, all of it, just the way it's laid is just I got a little gas station out here. Now, somewhere out here, if I'm not entirely mistaken, is an old Burlington Northern caboose, I think, which sits like right here in this little kind of triangle deal. I believe, I'm pretty sure. The very gorgeous area. Another big town on the map, kind of like Alliance, Nebraska. A damn good looking town at that too. It's just like there's nothing that rivals this. It's a flat out, it's not even a statement or opinion. It's a fact. There's nothing else that looks like this type of scenery in TS at all that looks this damn good. I mean, we don't have much in the way of the, you know, Midwest. We don't have anything in the Midwest, hardly in TS, or you know, the kind of near west, if you will, you know. Did I just stop the damn train? I did, by golly, son of a gun. That's all good. We're gonna look around Crawford anyway. How the heck that happened? We're still on the downhill grade. Come on, you stinker. Ah, hell with it. We'll give her a minute. She's tired. That hill was big. Working crossings, though, they look good as well. Just look at this, man. The road and the rails. God, that looks good. I cannot get over it. I cannot. I will not. Can't stop, won't stop. My little house is back in here as well. In the town of Crawford. It's moving day for somebody. United Rentals van. Looking very sharp, very crispy. Can't really see those anymore. You know, and the likes of Mayflower and what was the other big one? I remember seeing them as a kid all the time. Don't really see them much anymore. Here's kind of the big road that goes through town. We got some spare rail sitting there. I think I murdered our train because I killed it dead. Let me check on something here. What is the sand on? Not sure why the sand's on. This is an old VRC. They are very, I don't want to say temperamental, but more realistic than a lot of the stuff we got in the game, that's for damn sure. Anywho, kind of Main Street coming on through here. The town. I wonder, do they have more than one signal? Jack in the Box. Yeah, now we're talking. I have never been to one of these ever. I feel like they built one here near me in Orlando. I can't be certain. I think that it might have been a White Castle. I can't remember. And over here, I think there's a McDonald's, Mickey D's. It's stuff like this that just brings stuff like this alive and just makes it seem so much more realistic. I know, licensing, legalities, restrictions, all that crap, but you know, it still looks amazing. Choquero Taco Bell. Very nice. That a PH? The Hut? That's an OG Pizza Hut, right? Is that a Pizza Hut? It looks like an OG Pizza Hut, that roof like that. Got a Tejico sitting out here. Little floaters. This area might not be done entirely. It pretty much damn sure looks that way. But it's gorgeous, man. Little details that you don't normally see in routes. Like, look at the way these sidewalks kind of curve out from the street corner and go up under the bridge here. And they even have frickin' railings underneath, dude. Like safety barriers. You don't see that in TS ever, hardly ever. Hardly. Said that twice. Check on our train. She's still dead. Okay. That's an RIP for the old Dash 7s. Anyway, here is Crawford. This is where I did the video for the Searchlight Simulation BNS FSD-40-2 pack. Because I remember when I made it, there were a lot of people that was like, hey, that looks like Crawford. Where's that at? That looks like Crawford. So here we are now. Got a couple of helpers sitting there. I got some just rando pipe sitting back there. For whatever reason, I'm not really sure why I placed that. Some grain silos as well. Some just random cars. Bunch of ties and rails like this. You know, it looks like a little BNSF shop. You know, it's got these containers. Just crap laying around. Barrels, rails, ties, you name it. It, you know, it looks good. The lights, the trucks, pallets. It's like bags of concrete or quickrete. And the town itself looks amazing. Little substation right there. Is that the Pizza Hut? Yeah, it is. Okay. Another gas station. Here's the cattle market. Come and get your beeves. Complete with cattle trailers. I mean, look at this, dude. This looks amazing. I don't know if there is a cattle market asset in Train Simulator. I would be willing to bet there is not. But this looks bananas, dude. Just bananas. That's so good, man. Got all the hay stacked over here to keep them fed. You are going to make a delicious steak one day. I will see you again, friend, on my dinner plate. Next to a baked potato. Anyway, this area looks very cool. Good golly, Miss Molly. Good golly, Miss Molly. Our train's still dead. I don't know what the hell I did to it. But I reckon we'll go ahead and cut on to the next. Got a little gulch here. A little wet. Sometimes wet, sometimes dry gulch. But see, there's not water down here. But see, look what he did with the terrain. You know, made it darker. Like it can be wet versus like the terrain over here. Just paramount and premier craftsmanship. Absolutely. Oh, we got something dead in the woods over here. They're circling my engine. Cuckoo, cuckoo. A murder of crows. Anyway, moving right along. Hopefully. PCS was tripped. We're all right. For the sake of time, I'm just going to scooch on up to Edgemont, South Dakota. So we've effectively crossed the state line from Nebraska into South Dakota, but we're still on the Butte subdivision. The next subdivision is the Black Hills, aptly named for the area that it sits within. But anyway, as you can see here, it's a bit of an unfinished area. Again, he's laid down, you know, the basics. The only thing that needs to be finished up are the scenery for the most part. But it's only a tiny few sections because, as you see, we'll kind of just scooch up here. It'll start kind of popping in. Back behind us, it goes single track for a while. There's a little spur there. And then some stuff will start popping in here. See a bit of different terrain. He's got a bridge set up ready to go right there. Got the infrastructure and a lot of the signal boxes and stuff like that. Bit of the river. I want to say this is the Cheyenne River that starts snaking through here. But he's got some stuff placed here. Very nice bridge. Got some rocks and grasslands. These dry, rocky, dry cuts out here and old drainage beds and whatnot, and it's starting to be a bit more fleshed out here, as you can see, and it looks amazing. That's what's so damn good about this route, is it's something different. Every damn subdivision on this route is different, and there's like a fabillion subdivisions, I jest. There's like six, seven, eight, something like that. There's quite a few, and they look amazing from one to the next. And you know, the way the scenery can just be blended together and it still looks that damn good. I mean, look at that. Good god, it does though. It just looks amazing. We're gonna scooch on up here to Edgemont. What's that? Who that? Silos. There's a Earl Derrick up there. Nice. These are so cool. Mechanical dinosaur looking things. Freaky deaky. I think that's the Cheyenne River. If it's not, please fix me up. But it looks amazing, man. It's just totally different looking terrain out here. The colors, you know, I mean, look at the road. It's more of like a red dirt or clay, almost akin to Georgia red clay. It's got that, you know, that look to it. But by golly, you can definitely see some terrain rising up in the distance there. It is, though. It's just totally different from 1 mile to the next, this route. It is a... I should stop slobbering over it and clean myself up, but it's kind of hard not to. Got this tower right here. I believe that's the first one on the route. Hell, north of Bridgeport that I've seen, I think. Gradual rolling hills. It looks a little bit more arid out here to me. Got some coal trains set up ready to go. But jeez Louise. And by the way, this, what I loaded on here, this right here, this is a free roam. What I was saying in the first video, which I implore you again, if you've not seen it, go back and watch it, just to kind of get up to speed with this one in case you may have just stumbled across this one and don't really know what's going on. But this is from a free roam that's set up, that were lovingly and lavishly set up for this route to kind of get you familiar with the route itself and its operations. So this is just a free roam setup. You can choose whatever damn consist you want and slap it on the hiney and head towards the horizon. But it says Edgemont. I don't really want to go over Edgemont too much, because that's going to be in the next video, which is going to cover the Black Hills subdivision. And we're going to go check out that T90. You can see it kind of curving there off to the right. The little route that heads over to Deadwood, I believe, which goes that way. Because what's there is pretty nice. Pretty nice. And I hope it's finished out. But that's it, guys. We have arrived up in Edgemont. And that is the end of the Butte sub. Next up, I'm pretty sure it's the Black Hills sub, but there's a lot of cool stuff out this way as well. But we'll be on that in the next video. Hopefully not take more than about a week to get it all together and poorly edited and all that good stuff. But thank you, as always, for taking the time to watch. If you did watch this long, thank you once again, and I'll catch you on the next one. Take care out there. See you guys.